Location, Atlanta, Georgia. Time, Saturday, April 17th, 1982. It's a dreary day with threatening skies, but a bright spot here is ex-Chesapeake and Ohio locomotive number 2716. The Southern Railroad had recently acquired 2716 from the Kentucky Railroad Museum in Louisville and extensively rebuilt and modified her to have a distinctive Southern look. Originally located just above the air pump shield, the headlight has been boiler front centered with a Southern golden eagle perched atop in the manner of the long gone class PS4 Pacifics of Crescent Limited Service. Another major cosmetic change was the substitution of a tube type pilot in place of the original footboard style. She is the first steam locomotive on the Southern to carry a four-wheel trailing truck and probably looks just like what the Southern would have ordered should they have purchased 284s in their later steam days. Amtrak southbound Crescent to New Orleans arrives at Atlanta Peachtree Station and gets out ahead of 2716. The 2716 heads up one of the famous Southern Railroad steam specials. This day's heading for Chattanooga for a turnaround trip. A consist of 20 cars includes lightweights, heavyweights, a baggage, and an open observation car on the tail. The Southern Railroad has been running these steam specials for about 20 years now, and local railroad organizations generally sponsor most trips. The Atlanta chapter of the National Railway Historical Society is sponsoring both this and next weekend's runs to Toccoa. At Austell, we first spot the crescent, then 2716. Next, a small spot on the map called Hill City. Up the line a little, we stop at Phelps, where a southbound freight headed up by a Conrail SD-40-2, teamed with a Southern SD-35 and SD-45, gets by first. The 2716 next shows up northbound and unloads her passengers for a photo run-by. Thank you. 2716 next blast through the city of Dalton. At Chattanooga, our train is assisted into the station by an EMD GP35 on Alco trucks and a GP38-2. As the special clears the main, a southbound freight powered by a lash-up headed by another GP35 pulls out. Her passengers having been unloaded, the train is brought around to a servicing area. Built by the American Locomotive Company for the Chesapeake and Ohio in December 1943, 2716 weighs 460,000 pounds, has 69-inch diameter drivers, and produces 83,750 pounds of tractive effort with her booster engine. She was one of 90 class K4s built, and on the CNO was known as a Kanawha, a name given to honor the river along which she ran in service. The CNO presented 2716 to the Kentucky Railroad Museum in 1959, and she remained there until the Southern acquired her 23 years later.
Thank you.
The old familiar sound of the Alamite gun raps away as the steam locomotive is serviced for a return run to Atlanta. This crewman adds valve oil to the mechanical lubricator, a device which automatically feeds lubricant to many joints which require constant oiling while the engine is running. Looks like someone forgot to shut off the bathtub. Our crew will head back to Phelps to await 2716 southbound return, but unfortunately, many delays brought night well before 2716. So, a couple more diesel freights are taped to complete this day's recording. A northbound pulled by two SD-35s, two SD-40-2s, and an SD-45 comes first and is held on the siding. Next, two SD-40-2s and an SD-45 power a southbound. Finally, a coal train with two SD-40-2s on the point and another two of the same at mid-train. Thank you. The next weekend finds us back at Peachtree Station, where another steam special will originate. An eastbound freight pulled by two GP38-2s comes first, shortly followed by 2716 and train coming into the station. A short distance east of the station, the Southern's main line crosses over the seaboards and Peachtree Creek. A grade crossing at Sewanee is coming up. We're now a couple of miles east of Gainesville, and our train is moving about as fast as she can. Another photo run by is staged at Lula, and the train backs all the way around a curve and out of sight for this one. A grain storage tower at Alto is our next shooting location. She's arrived at Toccoa, and the crew takes a well-deserved break on top of her tender. 2716's cab interior is typical of a modern steam locomotive. That round object on the engineer's side is not a steering wheel. It's the actuator for the Franklin Precision reverse gear. The Toccoa layover ends and our special backs out of town to be turned and put back en route to Atlanta. The highway crosses high over the tracks at New Switzerland. Nearing Atlanta, she comes flying through Flowery Branch. Peachtree Station, and another Southern Steam special with Southern Chessie 2716 reaches an end.